Hello friends, I'm Dr. Rashi Singh, and today we are here to learn about the good educational materials and how to use them in the classrooms. Nowadays, we focus on the child-centered education, and it is very important to know that how the children are being taught and how they learn the different topics. And for this, we take help of various materials in our classroom. We call them teaching aids, we call them teaching learning materials. So, what is the need of teaching learning materials? Good educational material is not merely for the teacher to explain the topic or give information. Its purpose is much more than that. But then, why do we need it? If we say that we are not using the teaching learning materials appropriately, then how should we use the teaching learning materials in the class? Because it is very important for the teacher to understand that the teaching aids or the teaching learning materials that he or she is using in the class should be useful in all the aspects. So, we need to look and consider that how the children learn and what is their learning process. Because the teacher is dealing with the age group that is very sensitive, that is very that is in the initial stages of the school life. So the learning process, it is yet to be developed, and it should be like what stimulates the child's mind. So it is very important that we should have a complete understanding of the teaching learning process too, because it is the teacher, the child, and the teaching learning process that play a very important role in the classroom scenario. Let's understand what are the important points of teaching learning processes. For us, the human beings, we relate the new experiences or the new ideas to the previous knowledge, because when we teachers and we plan our lessons, the first point is previous knowledge testing. So whatever new knowledge is being acquired in the class by the child, it should be in context of our earlier knowledge or the previous knowledge, because only then we are able to relate and go to the next level of learning in the class. And for this, the concrete or the immediate experiences help the child to understand the concept better. For example, if we want to teach the concept of categorization to the children, we need to provide such materials that can help as and that can facilitate the learning, because they act as the concrete experiences for the child and they are based on certain properties on which the child can segregate them or categorize them. For example, the child can categorize on the basis of shape, color, weight, etc. So, it is very important that what we see, the learning becomes permanent, because for a child, it is very difficult to understand the abstract ideas, and all children learn the concept according to their own level of understanding. What they see, what they understand from it, and what they imbibe from it, what they absorb from it. As for example, this is a picture of a triangular prism that was made in the class by the teacher with the help of students. And it is having different shapes, different colors, but it is serving a purpose of a triangular prism. It is very important that we understand that what was the practice earlier, that is defunct nowadays. Earlier, it was teacher-centered learning or teaching process. Now, it is the learner-centered, the student or the child in the classroom, who is the main person for whom all the activities are planned, for whom the lesson plan is there, the various educational materials are there, the various specifications or specializations of a teacher are there. So, we presume we now warned that the student should not sit as a mere silent spectator or just as a listener in the classroom. He should be in an active role. He should be participating and interacting with the teachers and the different peers or the classmates in the classroom during the activities. To achieve this, we should make our teaching learning material as such that engages the student actively. And for this, we really need to come up with such activities or materials which are stimulating the mind of the young students. Now, it is very important to know how to use the teaching learning material. The teaching learning material is something, some educational material that is helping or that is facilitating the process of teaching and learning for the students. So, this material should be engaging for the students, in which they can participate and the students can manipulate and experiment with the teaching learning materials. It should not be something that is only for the display or mere for visual purpose. It should be something the students can touch, they can work on it, they can explore it, and they can go about in different directions for the same material, for the same subject. The students should be able to use the materials and perform the activities with them without the fear of being broken or spoiled. Because sometimes it so happens that we tell the children not to touch the educational material because we fear that the students might mishandle it and it might get broken. But that should not be the strategy. The strategy is to make learning interesting, and for that we really need to see, we really need to touch, we really need to work on that educational material, and that is how the purpose is served. Here we can see a teacher who is using different educational materials to teach different concepts of mathematics, to teach circle, the division, different parts. Now, we say that teaching learning materials should not be something that is just they are there in the classroom, but they should be considered as a platform of opportunity. The students can be playing with the material, exploring it, analyzing it, and being able to repeat those learning activities that the material offers opportunities for. The students are able to perform, they are able to experiment with the material, and then they can go according to their own imaginations, according to their own understanding levels, and they can perform different activities with the same material. For example, if we want to teach about some abstract notions, then we need to show their concrete expressions to help the students understand the concept better. If we show certain materials to the students, they are able to see it, understand it. They are able to manipulate them. They are able to understand what the need for that material is there in the teaching learning process. Eventually, the students would be able to understand and use the concepts without those concrete expressions, because they will be able to shift to the next level of learning. First, it is seeing, then touching, understanding, then you are able to understand the idea behind that material. So, it implies that the use of teaching learning materials is for the understanding of the concepts. Here, we see a child who is able to work with the educational material that has been provided to him in the class to understand the concept of number line. As we have said that the students should be given liberty to use the educational material according to their own level of understanding, and they should be able to explore them and work with the material. Students of different age groups, disciplines, and any stage of learning may understand the teaching learning materials differently. We say this because all students, all individuals are different in their own way. Then they belong to different age groups. They are studying different subjects and they might be in different stage of learning as in comparison with each other. And the level of understanding of the material provided to him or her may be different for each individual, for each student. Nature and mechanism of teaching learning materials may be different for different subjects, for different teachers, for different learners. It stands true for all the individuals who are there in the teaching learning process. We might be teaching English, we might be teaching maths, we might be teaching science, or we may be learning science, we may be learning English, we may be learning maths. So the stimulating environment that is provided to us by these teaching learning materials has a different impact, has a different impression, has a different ability to be developed in all the learners. Now, what is the purpose of teaching learning materials? Why do we need to use these teaching learning materials? As such, we can go in the class, lecture them, instruct them, discuss the topic. Why do we need? What is the need, purpose of teaching learning materials? We need to prepare such teaching learning materials whose function is not mere for display or to beautify a room. Because sometimes we see that whatever charts, models are being prepared by the students or by the teachers, they are put up for display or they are just being put up in one room and that room is beautiful. But that is not serving the real purpose of teaching learning materials. If the students are supposed to use them or explore them, then their nature should be as such that they are not damaged easily and they should not be very expensive too. The classroom where the students participate in the teaching learning activities, it should look attractive. It should be beautiful. But this attractiveness should not be in terms of looks only. The classroom where the students participate in the teaching learning activities, it should look attractive. But this attractiveness should not be in terms of looks only. The classroom should be such that where the children are able to perform different activities, it may not necessarily be beautiful with colored walls or materials hanging from the walls, but it should be useful and children should feel free and capable. The students should have a sense of ownership to the place. They should be able to do their own things. They should have that freedom. They should be allowed to touch the things and experiment with them and make the learning possible. Now, what can we do with just one material? We do not need a variety of stuff for preparing educational materials because we say that the teaching learning materials should be such that they are not very expensive and they should not be such that which can get damaged easily. And if the objectives are clear and we think carefully, then just one kind of material can have a lot of uses. This use can be done for one or more subjects. For example, we can use a cube or a dice to teach different concepts in mathematics. We can mark dots on the cube and use it as a dice. Or we can ask the students to collect pebbles and count and pick as the number comes on the dice to teach the number system. Students can also be taught to add, subtract or multiply by giving them to throw the dice 2 to 3 times and perform the desired function. We can throw the dice for some fixed number of times and record the total or the frequency of a number too. We can also ask them who got the highest or the lowest number on the dice and we can record those activities. We can place the cube on the paper to see the area it covers. Or the students can be asked to make different shapes on paper with the help of that cube. Similarly, many other materials can be used to teach different concepts in different subjects for different topics. So, today we have learned about the good educational materials, what is the purpose of educational materials, why we need them. We need to stimulate the mind of the children. The teaching materials should be such that the child is free to handle, the child is feeling capable of handling them, and they should be such that which are not damaged easily. And we can use one teaching material for different topics, for different subjects, and we need not have lot of resources, because sometimes it happens that the resources or the local resources are used for making these teaching learning materials, and these teaching materials can be made by the learners and by the teachers also. Thank you. We will meet again for a different session. Thank you.